Yo, what is up, my people? In today's video, I want to bring you a PvP build. I know the situation. I know how the dark zone is. I know the meta. I'm going to give you my advice, what I think right now. A lot of things are going to be changing soon on TU10.1. But for now, it's kind of like a foam war in the dark zone. It's a hazard v craziness, status, everything, bro. Like, you know, and if you want to be in the dark zone, you got to, like, be able to adapt, bros. You cannot be out here thinking that, you know, there's only going to be one build. There's many builds. There's one-shot builds. There's hazard builds. There's DPS builds. You know, and you got to find what works best for you. So today we're going to be covering a hazard build. I'm pretty sure you guys don't like getting foamed. I don't like getting foamed myself. I'm going to give you the best, like, opinions that I have, and I'm gonna give you a few different ways you can run it. But this is simply all you have to do to people, man. We were fighting these dudes. We came into the server, they were manhunt. They were pretty good players, no lie. They foamed a lot, but this is like, this is the whole encounter, you know. Like, if you get foamed, you know, if you foam me, I'm gonna foam you back. You know what I'm saying? I'm just sorry. That's just how it is, guys. You know, so if you don't like that, I'm sorry, I apologize, but okay. That's the way the game is, man. That's the way the Dark Zone is played, and you have to adapt, all right, guys? But with that being said, you know, if somebody's camping at the checkpoint or you guys are getting killed at the checkpoint, as these guys like to do to other players, just spawn in a different area in the safe room. There's a bunch of different checkpoints that you could farm at or spawn at. You don't have to, like, literally stay in the same area. As you can see, they foaming me, and it lasts barely a second. And we tested, we used a lot of different combinations to kind of get this result right here and have, like, high, insane damage outburst, you know, output. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoy this video, and let's get it. That was a long intro, man. But yeah, with this build, you're going to be able to, like, take a lot of stuff. Right here, my man hit me with a sticky, and I just, like, ate it, you know? So it's a really strong build. Build so nasty, even when you get caught off guard, you can still come back, bros. All right, you just got to use this the way I'm going to show you, man. I'm not even going to lie. Like, everybody I talk to or play against has been, like, super cool lately. But yeah, they foam me. I foam them.
PvP has come too.
This is what PvP has come to. Yeah, but this build works amazing even against people that have, like, good skill, you know? They work coordinated. This was a team we were fighting. They went out rogue. They went manhunt. We went manhunt. Same area, basically, we exchanged. And, yeah, we kind of overpowered them a little bit. And it was pretty fun, man. No lie. As you can see, they wiped us right there. And my man put in the chat, GG, that was fun. Which it was fun. And, you know, it's just like that. Like, we tried to come out. We were able to come out. You know, you got to either keep coming out if you want, if you're getting trapped in the checkpoint, or spawn somewhere else. You know, our choice was to keep coming out and trying to clear them before they go manhunt themselves, you know. And sometimes it's going to happen. Sometimes it's not. That's just the game. You know, I just noticed, like, a lot of people really, like, take it personal when you, like, camp checkpoints or something like that. And I just want you guys to know, like, it's not really a big deal, in my opinion. It's only a game, you know. But before we start talking about the build, I want to give you, like, a tip. I would say when you use this build, try to be aggressive and try to be, like, on top of people. Because if you're not, you're not going to get the armor. You're not going to get the intimidate proc. And your damage is not going to be enough. Okay, guys? So make sure you're keeping that in mind. The lady does do work. All right, my people, here we are to your favorite part of the video, all right? So I'm going to explain everything about this build. I'm going to give you some options right here. So first off, YOLO, baby. This is the build, okay? So with this build, I'm able to do so much damage, in my opinion, that I'm able to fry most people, especially if they're, like, any type of glass cannon. If they don't have, like, more than two blues, bro, they're getting absolutely smoked. Okay, so blues really matter in PvP, man. You want to try to get your armor, depending if you're a solo player or a group player. I would say your armor should be anywhere from 1.3 to 1.5 if you're solo. That way you can kind of, like, you know, react a little bit. But at the same time, man, sometimes you're going to die so fast. Like, it's not going to matter how much armor you have, especially if you're getting focus fired. you know, and there's some pretty sweet builds out there, like the one-shot sniper and, you know, a lot of very strong skill builds. So with that being said, though, this is going to basically keep you alive from anybody that's using fire starter, any type of fire, any type of bleed, any type of disrupt and ensnare, which is the foam, which is one of the biggest issues I feel. And they're going to be changing it in 10.1. But with the foam, you only get stuck for not even like a second. It is the fastest like exchange. I feel like they're wasting more time aiming at you, trying to stick you, than you are actually going to be stuck. So with that being said, man, this is what you're looking for, all right? So you're looking for two Seska. That's going to give you hazard protection, okay? Each of these pieces should have hazard protection, all six of your pieces, all right? This is going to give you 60%, okay? And then we're getting 10% more from Seska, which is going to give us 70. 10% more from y'all, which is going to give us 80. And then your watch is going to give you 90%, okay? Your watch is going to give you 10 more percent on top of that 80, which is going to make it 90. And then you're going to have two blues, three blues if you want. So three blues would be, you could actually put this build anywhere you want. As long as you have good gear, wherever you want to put this, you can put these pieces, okay? So you just need to make sure you have two Seska, one y'all. I would suggest two Sokolov personally, because it gives you SMG and crit hit damage. But you know, that's totally preference, up to you. And then Fox Prayers, right? So if you don't have Fox Prayers, I would tell you right now, either use a third Sokolov or use a Grupo piece, okay? Make sure that piece has hazard protection and you're set, all right? I promise you, you are absolutely gonna booty blast anybody you see in the dark zone, anywhere else. I promise you, man, as long as you're playing PvP, this build is gonna rip and protect you, okay? So right here, I'll just click on each piece real quick. So armor, I suggest having like 3 to 4 armors. I run a little bit more reds because I play with a team. You know, usually my viewers join me and sometimes we have a healer. So, you know, I would spec more into red if I have a healer, you know, but I just swap some pieces around. But for you, some of you guys are solo, you know, even on console, this build is good for you guys. I promise you, even on console, I already know this is going to rip. Okay, so it has nothing to do with headshots. It's all your effort, your grind. You got to farm these pieces. You got to get the good rolls. You got to get what you want on them. Okay, you need to have hazard on each piece of gear. If you get something that drops with hazard already on it, that's beautiful. Keep that piece. Make sure you put some armor on this build. All right. I would highly suggest, if you're having trouble, I would suggest using 5 blues, okay? Like, honestly, it's kind of wild, but the Lady Death is going to help you with that damage that you lack, okay? All right, so on top of that, I'll just show you some of my stats real quick. You could get a higher crit hit damage if you have better pieces of gear. 55 crit chance. If you want to, you could spec that red mod into crit chance to get that 60. I'm fine with 55 personally, but 60 is definitely the goal. All right, so right here we have a hazard protection and we're at 89% because one of our pieces of gear doesn't have a max roll. So this is basically 90%, right? 89.6. So right here I have 99% bleed resistance because I have a blue mod in my backpack that's gonna make me immune to any bleed. So Stinger Hive, I'll get hit with the initial skill damage, but I won't bleed, okay? All right, right here we have Blind Death. We have burn resistance 100%. All right, so Firestarter is getting changed next patch and you're still gonna need fire resistance. All right, guys, the main reason is because most of the people you're gonna run into are gonna run firewall. I want to say most because not everybody will, but firewall is very strong, and when you're playing a close range build and you break somebody's armor, they set you on fire, anybody that's within 5 meters. So it's really easy to get burned in this game right now. So with that being said, burn resistance 100% easy. I'm gonna show you the way. All right, confuse, disrupt. So if you get EMP'd, I'm using a disrupt mod with 9%, which gives me 99%. But if you get EMP'd, you won't get any effects. Nothing will happen to you. All right, and snare right here, we're at 89%, almost 90%. So what that means is that when we get ensnared by the foam, it's literally not even gonna take a second for you to get out of there. So don't worry. When you get foam, just keep shooting and moving, because as soon as that status effect is over because of your resistance, you're going to be on the same goal, okay? It's just a stop of your movement with this build, all right? Nothing else. It's not going to keep you stationary. You're not going to have to press F, none of that, okay? So with that being said, let's move on to the next pieces, all right? So I showed you my mask. I have crit hit damage hazard on it. I rolled the disrupt mod. I also have the backpack with hazard and crit hit damage with bleed resistance. All right. So our two talents are going to be, of course, close range talents. And that's going to be adrenaline rush. All right. So whenever you're within 10 meters of an enemy, you gain 20% bonus armor for 5 seconds. It stacks up to 3 times. So if you're solo and a team runs at you, you're going to get 60% armor right there like that. And every 5 seconds, you're going to keep getting it. So that's why I suggest these talents, because you could play up close and stay up in team's face. All right. Remember, though, if you are in a bad position and you get bursted, you're going to die no matter what. Okay. All right. So right here, we have weapon damage on the two Sokolovs, which I have gloves and chest. Like I said, you can mix and match this however you want. But hazard protection. And then we have a crit hit chance right here. I would have loved crit hit damage, but I'll take crit hit chance because I'm not at max anyway. So max crit damage mod. Well, actually, you could use a Seska piece if you wanted to, and then swap out like a Sokolov right here. It's all up to you and like the pieces you have, but you can mix and match easily and still get the same result. All right, guys. So I was mistaken. I thought that y'all had the blue mod slot, but y'all has red. But Seska has blue. So if you wanted to, you could run the two Seska up top and have your two blue mod slots, right? Giving you 20% more resistance in any category. All right. So right here, we're going to go with y'all. And hazard, of course, armor. My Fox Prayers, I wrote hazard protection onto them with damage to outer covers, which is really nice. And then here we have Sokolov gloves with hazard protection, again, with crit hit damage, weapon damage. Right now, I'm liking the mix of having my Sokolov chest and my Seska mask. And this combination is really working well for me, man. The Lady Death is a phenomenal weapon. I have a good amount of damage on it. Brief free talent is super beautiful. You gain 4 stacks per second, 8 stacks if you're sprinting, up to 32 stacks. So one magazine, basically. And each round fired consumes a stack, amplifying damage by 75% per stack, guys. So kills grant 20% movement speed for 10 seconds. And I use that to catch up to rogues that are running from me usually. All right. So right here, we're going to use Riot Foam. Like I said, very strong skill. They'll be changing it once they come with the changes. I'll drop you another video. So make sure you subscribe to the channel. Turn on notification so you can be part of the notification gang. And right here we have Crusader Shield. So Crusader Shield lets me use my SMG and gives me that extra layer of protection so that they're not doing damage to me unless they're hitting headshots, which I want you guys to try your best to hit headshots. But if they're shooting me in the body, of course, the shield's going to take all that damage because they're going to be shooting the shield. So I just try my best to aim at the head. I sometimes am a Pepega, but usually I try my best to hit headshots. So right here, I'm going to go to the specialization that I think you should run. And the main reason is going to be Demolitionist gives you 20% burn resistance. All right. That's the main reason we're using this. If you don't care for that burn resistance or your build already is elite and you have all the hazard protection in the universe you could want, definitely consider using a different tree, maybe Firewall. But right here, we could use that resistance and we get Demolitionist Tactical, which is 5% damage to out of cover target. So on top of all your damage, you're gonna have that 5%. And I love this build, man. Honestly, ignore an explosion every 60 seconds. Make sure you're running your weapon damage. And with that, that's the whole build, man. I hope I really am helping you guys out there, and I appreciate all the support you guys been giving me. Make sure you pass by the Twitch later. We'll be live around, I want to say, 3 to 4 p.m. Eastern. All right, I got a funny thing right here for you. My man was telling me to go rogue, and then I told him to go rogue, and he didn't notice that we were in a regular dark zone, but he killed himself and his whole team. It was kind of funny. That guy was awesome, man. That guy was awesome. He was a cool dude, though. Salute. Take care of yourself. Hit me up if you got any questions or, you know, you need to talk to anybody. Much love, baby.